Hello.
It's me, Matthew. For those that are unfamiliar with me, I am one of the co-hosts of Book Club for Masochists, a Reader's Advisory podcast, which is a podcast in which we read a different genre or format of books every month, everything from gardening to erotic romance. In August, just last month, we did visual novels as our format, which is really interesting. A lot of us didn't have a lot of experience with those, so I streamed visual novels every day for a month, which was kind of stupid, to be totally honest, but also fun. And I decided that because I like spooky things and I like streaming, I was going to keep streaming something, and it's spooky dating simulators. So tonight is going to be Halloween Hearts, and hopefully every Friday night from here on out, I'll be streaming. Mostly with co-hosts. I have several other co-hosts scheduled. If you watched my other streams, there are some of the same people, some new people, and they will be joining me to date spooky monsters and things like that. I think it'll be fun. We'll see. If you have any suggestions for what spooky visual novels, and by spooky I mean filled with ghosts and witches and demons and stuff, and not actually scary. I do not... While I love horror, while I love spooky stuff, I'm not actually a big fan of horror in general. So, not like some of it's okay, but really we're aiming at like dating vampires and werewolves and not like having our skin flayed off or something like that. Anyway, so if you have a recommendation, drop it in the chat, leave a comment, whatever it is. Also, if you have a recommendation for like spooky goth makeup that you really like, you can tell me that as well. I'm into learning more about that. Even if you just know like a good eye makeup tutorial or something, you can also do that. Anyway, let's get started with this game. Oh, thanks, Super Dead Smurf, for following me. But here's Halloween Hearts. So we're dating. We have multiple. There's I think like 10 or 11 endings in this one, and most of them are bad, so we're probably going to get one of those, but I think it'll still be fun to do this. So, here we go. Slow to start up. Okay, I'm not entirely sure how long I've been walking. After the coach, it was a short bus ride. And then, after walking straight through the forest as instructed, my destination would be right in front of me. Then how come, after walking for a good hour, I still haven't arrived yet? Well, I guess it depends on how full the forest is, how much of that there is. Dot dot dot. My favorite thing in visual novels. Every single one of them seems to have this. Are those pumpkins growing in trees, or are these like... Oh no, okay. Those are like the ground. I thought I was looking up for some reason. All right, an hour's probably an exaggeration, but it certainly feels like one. I must have taken a wrong turn somewhere. I pass through endless trees, unidentifiable creatures, and plants. I'm not sure where to track back to, as everything looks the same. I assume the best thing I can do is keep moving forward. In all honesty, it wouldn't be that bad if I knew where I was going. And if I could shake off the feeling of being watched. I'm really reminded right now of years ago, I was visiting my friend's farm. Because I have a number of friends who are farmers, even though I maybe do not look like someone like that. And I was helping them harvest their vegetables in their field. And there was a very funny photo of me in like, I can't remember exactly what it was, but I was wearing like pretty ridiculous like goth pants and like picking zucchini or something. It was pretty amusing to me at the very least. Okay. Ever since I arrived here, that feeling has been looming over me, making the hair on my skin prickle up. I do not have a pumpkin yet this year, and maybe I will get one soon. I think they're available. I've been walking for so long, I've almost forgotten why I'm here. All right, I should gather my thoughts. My name is... Oh, what's my name? Any suggestions for what my name should be? What's the name I usually go with in these? Oh, yeah. My, like, default name in so many games is Estelle. I think I'm a female character in this? Oh, maybe it doesn't really matter. This is from, like, I think it was, like, Legend of Mana a billion years ago for the PlayStation. Had, like, a random name generator, and that was, like, the one that it gave me, and that's been, like, a name that is uncommon, and so none of my friends have it, and so I can easily use it whenever I'm asked for a name in a game. Okay. I currently study at Miskatonic University, because, of course, that's where I study. In my free time, I like to... Do I write stream visual novels? maybe not. Do I write read books? Because that is what I like to do in my free time as well. I'm going to write make a podcast, because that is also what I do, and I think this is funny. My name is Estelle. Recently, I started study at Miskatonic University, and right now, I wish I was at home so I could make a podcast. Great. Sigh. Today is a pretty important day. I'm one of the first humans to exchange at Earth's new university for monsters. It'll only be for a week, but if it goes well, maybe I could create a peace between humans and monsters. Anyway, just let me take my sweater off. I had to close my window so that there's less car noise, and then it makes my room warmer. How did monsters appear on Earth anyway? I was little, so my memory's a little fuzzy, but if I recall correctly, about a decade ago, monsters started showing up from different dimensions. Monsters are what we call these creatures, although I suppose calling them aliens makes more sense. We have no idea how or why these wormholes started showing up. Some say events that shape the universe leave cracks fragile enough to rip holes through different dimensions. Maybe an event in another distant universe left cracks in ours. Or maybe our universe was fragile to begin with. Either way, I'll leave that up to scientists to figure out. I kind of wish now that I'd, like, written do science experiments as what I like to do in my spare time. I could be the scientist. Okay, there's no denying it. That wasn't my imagination. I definitely heard something. If you're in the woods, it's probably like a rabbit or a squirrel. It's probably a squirrel. Turn around or keep walking. Let's just keep going. I decide to pick up my pace. Not because I'm scared, of course. I want to hurry up and leave this forest. That is exactly how I feel in real life. No reason loitering around here for too long. Spending time in nature is not my number one thing to do. My stride turns into a jog, and before I know it, I've started running. However, that is also not a thing that I do. It feels good for a while, with the autumn leaves crunching under my shoes and the slight adrenaline pumping through my veins. Until I fall. Thunk. I roll into a part of the forest that dips down. I tumble and tumble and don't stop, until my body connects to the ground. I land right into a grassy terrain. I feel a considerable amount of soreness on my arms and stomach, but my right leg seems to have gotten the worst of the impact. That's not good. I think my ankle might be sprained. That's what you get for running, and also for going into nature. Or worse. Hey, are you okay? I hear a worried voice from above. My first thoughts are, is this an angel? Definitely an angel, obviously. Look at them. But when I look up, my mind goes numb. I want to answer, but I suddenly find that I'm unable to make any noise. It wasn't her inhuman skin, nor her eight eyes that made me climb up. Eight eyes? I only see two. No, my attention was brought to something more unnatural and frightening below her hips. Oh, is she a spider person? What are they called? I can't remember what spider people are called. Oh yeah, spider person. Although they only have six legs, it seems. Driders. Yes, thank you, Super Dead Smurf. I knew it was something like that. Beneath her waist was the body of a spider, complete with six beastly stick-like legs. Six legs? I guess they have two arms? I guess that makes eight limbs? I'm conflicted about whether a spider person would have eight legs and additional limbs. Like, a centaur has four, like, horse legs and two human legs. So I feel a spider would have eight legs and then two human arms. Or maybe more human arms. I don't know. It looked like some kind of eldritch horror or a work of fiction brought to life. Stay calm, scream. Well, I knew I was going to the Monster City, Monster University, so I knew they existed. But this is also still kind of scary. But it's really rude to scream, so I'm gonna stay calm. I can't help but notice you've fallen about 10 meters. Are you okay, or is this normal for humans? I'm glad the spider is using the, like, you know, proper spelling of meter and stuff. And also saying we're using autumn, so great. Definitely not normal. And human legs aren't supposed to bend like that, right?
No.
Oh, I should add this to my diary. Okay, human, let me help you get back to your human village. Ah, wait. You must be the exchange student for our Earth Studies class, right? That's a pretty big jump to make. I thought those were eyebrows on this character's forehead, but maybe they're also eyes? I guess they look more like spider eyes. I can't imagine why a human would be here today for any other reason. The pain makes it hard to concentrate on what she's saying, but I managed to let out a feeble reply. Yeah, I'm Estelle. It's nice to meet you, Estelle. My name is Cthulia. The most know me as Chia. Cthulia. I'm the student representative for the class. All right, enough dawdling, Estelle. Let's go. You're the only one that's dawdling. What should I do? Cthulia. Yes, Cthira Severnaya. Cthulia, indeed. Let her help you. Don't let her help. Well, like, she's nice. I want to be nice to these monsters. The goal is to date them, so I'm going to let her help me. I don't want to bother her, but I realize that I may not be able to walk on my own. Please do. All right. With ease, Chia picks me up and positions me on her back. There we go. I flinch at the touch of her body. It's hairy like a tarantula, but just long, thin legs similar to daddy long legs. They don't seem very daddy long legs like to me, but I guess if you scaled one up, it would be... they'd be thicker legs? Also, like, I guess centaurs don't wear pants, but, like, should this person be wearing pants? How does a spider centaur wear clothing? It seems all the properties of a spider blended into one giant amalgamation of a spider. You know, jumping spiders can carry around 170 times their body weight. Yeah, SVN. Right, it's like Donald... it is like Donald Duck, indeed. Like, it seems weirder. Like, if we get to, like, some sort of, like, swimming scene or something, and there's, like, a towel wrapped around the bottom of the spider, I'm gonna be very confused. Although their sense of gravity is different from ours. Arachnids can carry over 200 times their body... their weight. Isn't that amazing? That's my race, by the way. I'm an arachnia. The average human can lift around 2 to 3 times their weight. I certainly cannot lift 3 times my weight. I think that is grossly overestimating how much I can lift. She continued like this for a while. Despite her appearance, her voice was as smooth as silk. Really? Silk? Spider? The once frightening fur felt like a soft pillow beneath my body. I closed my eyes and drift off into- whoa. That's a big change. I don't know if I'd fall asleep on the spider person that's carrying me around. An unidentifiable amount of time has passed. My body is engulfed with silk. I hear muttering. Curio Amora. Estelle should be all better now. Thank you, Alice. I recognize the voices to belong to Chia and... wait, Alice? I open my eyes. Okay, what do we think Alice is going to be? A witch! Oh, you've awoken, Estelle. Sorry, I wasn't sure where to put you, so I left you in my room. This is Alice. She's a magician. A magician. Okay, I was going to make a ghost spider comment earlier about the spider person, Chia, and there is ghost spider / spider Gwen in the poster on her wall. That's very cute. I like that a lot. Although I am highly suspicious of the book on the right hand side there on the table. I prefer the term witch. Magician makes it sound like I'm going to pull a rabbit out of my hat. Magician is a fraught term. It is indeed seed, though magic users in general kind of have a lot of conflicting terms for what they are. Alice, is that you? Estelle, it's been a while, huh? Oh, so I know Alice. I wonder if Alice was a witch before last time I knew them. Alice, my childhood friend. A memory of her flashes in my mind. I'm sure I've been friends with her for longer than I can remember. She's been with me through thick and thin. And up until recently, we had been going to the same school. When we graduated, I ended up at Miskatonic University. And, well, I didn't hear from her for a while. And although we weren't the closest, she seemed more fond of me than I was of her. It was reassuring to see a familiar face. I'm not ecstatic about reuniting like this, but what can you do? You two know each other? It's a long story. We just went to the same school is all. Oh, I want to know. Does that mean you went to a human school, Alice? A human school? The magic user? Alice sighs. We should probably get going to her class, right? Ah, you're right. Although I'm not sure Miss would mind. You know how she is. Alice is defined by Chia. I'm kind of... I think it's kind of confusing to me that the spider person just brought me to her bedroom instead of, like, the school medical clinic, health clinic, you know? You'd hope they have one of those? Not knowing how to get there, I quickly scramble my way up, shaking away loose cobwebs that stuck to my clothing. I grab my bag and leave the room without trying to step on any spiders. How would a spider person feel about spiders? I don't know. Along the way, I get to listen to Chia's extended dialogue about the history of monsters and the creation of this university. She then starts to talk about wormhole theories and how arachnids and humans could coexist and even reproduce. Huh? Please don't talk about that. Kira, maybe how we feel about small monkeys? Like, okay, but like, there aren't small monkeys in the corner of my bedroom right now. And if there were, I'm not sure how I would feel about them. I zone out for most of it, instead focusing on the architecture of the university. The doors are huge to enable access for multiple monsters of all sizes. Accessibility, very important. There are also signs everywhere in so many different languages. Many of them seem alien to me. Lit by candles, which seems like a fire hazard? And toilets for every type of species. We're here, it's the door on the right. I suddenly feel nervous, but before I can say anything, Chia gently pushes me in the room. I step into the classroom and I'm surprised to see not that many monsters. Alice and Chia seem to have made their way to their seats. Chia smiles while Alice gives me an unreadable look. In the year 2030, we are expecting to see a large increase in monster kind if these wormholes continue to appear at their current rate. A slime in a lab coat is talking. A slime in a lab coat is talking. I can't believe this. This is fantastic. Ah, human, you finally managed to make it to our human studies class. Tardiness in this classroom is punishable by lynching. My heart skips a beat. What? I'm pulling your human leg. I am Nebula Udra. Please call me Nebula. How does the cube wear lab coat? Magic, obviously, I think, is very obvious, is the answer. I'm just having this, like, very, like, the mind image of all of the monsters, like, weird, like, how My Little Pony fans use terms like every pony. I assume that monsters who are really into, like, human-based media are all like, okay, now every human, we have to go do this thing. So, yeah. Okay. Nebula that turns around to face their students. Class, this is Estelle from Miskatonic University. Da, da, da. For 1 week, they will be studying here. During that time, we can learn from each other's customs and cultures. And by next week, you need to produce a report about this experience. There's an audible groan. If Nebula had a mouth, I'm sure she would be grinning. Please, Estelle, take a seat wherever you please. Now, who should I sit with? Sit with Chia, sit with Alice, sit elsewhere. Okay. The spider lady was nice, but she is also, like, the student representative, so, like, the student council person or whatever. Not really my first choice. Alice didn't seem to be super big into seeing us, and also, the goal is to, like, date monsters and not, like, human magic users. So I'm gonna go with elsewhere, I think. Sit elsewhere. It's not like I have to sit with either of them. Two other students catch my eyes. One was tall and muscular. She had two huge wolf-like ears. If it was not for her wolf-like tail, I might have thought she was a cat girl. But she must be a werewolf, right? The other one was a very classical vampire. He was dressed in dark colors and even donned a cloak. I guess you can wear anything here? Cloaks are gonna come back in fashion in 2030. Like, listen to me. Kira, a completely regular bird in the human hand is worth two completely regular birds in the non-human eating bush. Yes, exactly. Just make all of the, all of our sayings about specifically with humans. Okay, do you want to go with the vampire who has a cloak, or the werewolf who has ears? Or I can just sit alone. I wish I could see pictures of them, because that would really help me choose which one I want to go with. Let's just sit alone. I'm going to be, like, a total weirdo. Not total weirdo. I'm just going to be very introverted at this point. I decide to sit on my own. Slime teacher asks for my input, and I try to give experience of being a human. Reckless D, you can wear a cloak in the regular universe too if you're not a coward. I am reminded, I'm also very amused, the auto moderator just took the word coward and prevented your message from getting posted immediately. So apparently coward is a term that that Twitch does not like people using. You can indeed wear a cloak at university, and honestly I guess a lot of people do at graduation ceremonies, so it's not like they're uncommon university clothing. But, you know. Okay. My experience being human, that is seems like something I would actually have a problem like doing. Monsters look at me in awe. I don't really like being the center of attention, so I can't wait till it's over. After a lengthy and tiresome lesson is over, my table gets swarmed with company. Oh, a real human in the flesh. I can see why they thought this was a cat person. That kind of looks more cat person-y than wolf person. My name is Lyra. Lyra? Okay, it's lycanthropy, so it's probably Lyra. A tall blonde spoke up. She had fluffy ears and a tail that won't stop wagging. That seems weirdly sexual? I don't know. This one must be a werewolf, right? Heh, what's it like being surrounded by so many higher beings, mortal? Darius, no one thinks you're cool. The ones you just called Darius must be a vampire. He's dressed in tacky cosplay, like a kid wearing a store-bought Dracula costume for Halloween. Mermaid girl, hey, what's human school like? A tale that just won't quit. That is exactly what I was thinking. That is, like, you know, the like, detective noir version of a werewolf. It's like, oh, the werewolf, the tall, blonde werewolf in the red dress walked into my office, and she had a tale that just won't quit. What's human school like? Zombie guy, I bet their brain stays good. Mermaid girl, is that all you ever think about? Pumpkinhead, you're getting drool everywhere. Shinigami, which is like a Japanese demon sort of thing. Demon in quotation marks, spirit thing. It's not common for humans to eat each other's brains. I hear earth food is pretty grotesque. Oh, we eat pumpkins, Pumpkinhead, so definitely grotesque to you. I get pummeled with question after question. How are you enjoying your time here, human? I hear earthlings eat pumpkins and even mix them into pies for flavor. That's just a myth, right? I personally do not eat pumpkins. Pumpkin pie, at least. I'm not a big fan of that sort of pie. Definitely not my number one pie choice. Brains, heart. Whoa, Now, everyone. I think our human is a little tired. Need help finding your way to your dorm? I don't know where my dorm is, so yeah, let's go with yes. Now then, shall we get going? Let's. I will show you to your dorm. Chia guides me out of the classroom, shooing away the other monsters. Maybe I should have just gone by myself and just wandered around lost. Okay, next time. I'm glad you're friendly, Estelle. Same to you. You're saying to the person that chose not to sit next to you in class and not to sit next to anybody and just sit by themselves. We unfortunately had an incident with another group of humans here. Chia's eight eyes seemed to look pensive at the ground. We weren't always just a university. We had a lot more buildings, a college, a secondary and primary school. Ah, but I won't bore you with the details. Chia looks up at the room labeled spare in English with a few translations below it. We're here. Well, I'll see you tomorrow, Estelle. It was nice meeting you. Let me know how your leg feels tomorrow. With a nod, I walk back to my dorm. What was Chia talking about? I did think it was weird to have only one university here. Usually universities come individually, or maybe this person is using university in a different definition than the one I am used to. Then what happened? I close the door behind me and chuck my bag to the floor. I think about calling my family and telling them I'm fine, finishing off my notes from class, or writing down ideas for my comic about assassins on my phone. But after that tiring first day, all I can do is collapse on my bed and fall into a deep sleep. It's morning time, and a surprisingly bright and sunny day. Greetings! I thought you might need some help getting to class. Is Chia in my bedroom? That is not cool of me. Cool of you, Chia. Cool? Well, if you say so. I'm early, so monsters aren't already at their seats yet. Lyra, Estelle, you should join a club. That's true. Since you came here to get an understanding of how monsters are, it would be a good experience if you joined a club, you know, in the 6 days that you're here. Of course, you could always help with my student representative duties. Not helping with those. Hey, mortal, you should try on my classic horror club. Also not happening. We watch old scary movies and read ancient human mythology. That isn't a real club. It is. You don't even have to join, mortal. You can try a taster session. Okay. Admission. In university, I took a German film class and asked somebody on a first date to the showing of Nosferatu that we watched in that class. So that is the sort of student I was in university. Estelle, you should join me on the athletics team. Wolf, have you seen Estelle? They look more like the kind of person that stays inside watching and reading things than running outside. Very true. Like you? Precisely. Alice pipes up. You don't have to join a club. Why don't you help me with my spells? I could use an extra hand or two, especially when it comes to potion making. Okay, Alice is a human, right? Like, are they... I don't know. Like, I went to school with them. They know all about the human world, too. Why don't I help? That sounds fun. No way, you'd end up eating the ingredients. Is that... racist? Should I join a club? Help Chia with representative duties? Athletics doesn't sound too bad. I enjoy sports once in a while. Casting spells with a real witch sounds interesting. Or I could try out Darius's club, whatever that is. Help with student rep activities, join the athletics club, visit the classic horror club, work on spells with Alice, or choose none. Well, I'm not leaning in any particular way, so I'm open to suggestions if anyone feels strongly about any of these. Help with student rep activities, join the athletics club, visit the classic horror club, work on spells with Alice, choose none. I'm leaning towards the athletics club or the classic horror club, but like Darius seems like a dork. Which one? Athletics or spells? Okay, well, I was thinking athletics or horror, so let's go with athletics. Yay, I know you'll enjoy it, Estelle. Let's go straight away. The lesson hasn't even started yet. Then let's go after. I decided to sit next to Lyra during class. What made you like sports in the first place? What sports do monsters play? Oh, there's got to be a pun here. What is a monster sport? What is a normal sport? I can't remember any sport names now. Oh, basketball? That's good. I was going to say casketball. Maybe vampires play casketball? And basketball? Maybe they're two different sports. Oh, come on, Estelle. It's my life. Being a werewolf, I'm naturally good at everything active. But it's not like I don't work hard. I work really hard, you know, to become strong. It's really important. I'm strong. It's good you have something you're passionate about. Mm-hmm. When the lesson ends, Lyra is practically jumping out of her seat. Finally, we can go. The werewolf girl grabs my hand and pulls me outside. We arrive at a large area covered in grass. The area is vast and empty, and the floor is covered with grass. The floor? The only part of the ground that isn't full of grass terrain is the racing track encircling the entire field. Huh, this place actually has a pretty huge garden. I know, it's a great space for us to run and exercise. I thought it'd be more gym-like. Gym? You know, exercise machines, bikes, weights. Lyra tilts her head quizzically. Never mind. I'll race you to the finish line. Whoa, wait, right now? Yep, I want to see how fast humans are. I also need to gauge your strength to see how and where we need to improve. Don't worry, I'll be right behind you. All right. I was really hoping to play like basketball and not just running. I start with a slow pace as I know how many times I rushed into running that have still really regretted it, such as yesterday while running through the forest when I fell down a hole. What becomes a slow jog eventually turns into a half jog, half run. For a while, I managed to keep myself at a consistent tempo. This is like when I ran in the forest yesterday. Actually, I don't want to think back to that. I breathe through my mouth as I try to keep the pace up. Huff, fa. I look down and concentrate on the ground. My feet wobble with every further step I take. My legs start to feel weak and unstable. I've got to have run like at least like, what, 20, 30 meters? I worry that they'll give. Maybe if I close my eyes, I can try to focus on keeping myself stable. That seems like a very bad idea. I try not to pay attention to the pain in my body and tell myself to keep moving. Ha, puff. How unfit was I, Fairy? I'll admit, the only exercise I'd gotten is the once-in-a-blue-moon days when I ran for the bus. But I didn't think I was this unhealthy. I can feel the cold sweat trickle down my face and shirt, along with the soreness and stiffness in my body and the aching of my muscles. It's an uncomfortable reminder of why I never exercised in the first place. I decide this is a bad idea, and I'll probably trip again if I continue to close my eyes. Yep. When I open my eyes, my jog turns into a stride. I don't see Lyra behind me or in front of me. Did I manage to beat her? No chance. Most likely not, right? But the thought of outrunning a werewolf ignites my competitive side. I push myself to cross the line where I first started. Finally, I reach the finish line. Huff, I did it. Good job! She ruffles my hair. Huff. As if she had run at lightning fast speed, Lyra appears next to me. My knees give in, and I collapse on the ground. I try to regulate my heartbeat and take in deep breaths of air. I brought you some water. I am unable to speak, my throat is hoarse, and I'm gasping for air. This seems like... I'm not sure why this person... why I tried so hard in this, to be honest. I barely nod as she hands me over the bottle. And while you were running... I ran this track three times over while you were running. That was fun. Let's go again three more times. I'm tired and practically wheezing, but I managed to breathe out one word. No. I'm completely and utterly exhausted. If you say so, I'll be running again, so you're free to join me. I nod, although I know for certain I won't be running a game today. I lay down and watch as Lyra runs the track 8 more times before getting out of breath. What happened to 3? Athletics Club appears to be one person. Rare for autumn to be so hot. I wonder if the cracks in the universe are affecting our climate. No, it's just climate change. My whole body is sore from yesterday. Everything was a blur last night, but I remember falling asleep straight away. It's all that running I did, the one time around the track. I should probably have stretched before I ran that track. Or at least only ran half of it. Well, whatever. I make my way to class. It's too hot. All right, settle down, settle down. The gelatinous cube is great. When Nebula comes in, I'm surprised that she's not a steaming puddle of slush. We managed to make it through the blistering hot session lesson. I guess vampires are like very cold in general, but like even Darius must be kind of warm wearing a cloak indoors when it's hot. The great eternal fire of Iblis, that blasted demon is burning too brightly today. He drains my life force. Are you talking about the sun? We should go swimming. That's what you do in times like these, right? I know a small sandy area near the ocean. I think it should be safe enough to swim in. Huh, that actually doesn't sound too bad. Let's go, Estelle. Oh, can I not go swimming? Oh, apparently no. We take a few wrong turns out of the university, but we eventually arrive at a quiet sandy area against the sea. Okay, so the last university that I went to had a beach right by the ocean that was just down a bazillion stairs because it was, I guess, kind of high up. Anyway, one of the beaches was a nude beach. People went down there to drink a lot and then had to climb back up the stairs while drunk, which was not a good idea for them. Still, Wreck Beach. Yes, indeed. That is the name of it, Kira. Seraphinia. Wreck Beach. Yeah. Okay. We get to the sandy area against the sea. Oh, all of us came. Swimming! Ah, be careful, Lyra. The sun burns. Maybe I should have hung out with Darius at his movie club. Why did I come again? If you set up your umbrella above my towel, Darius, we could probably create a spot safe from the sun. Lyra excitedly jumps into the ocean and started doggy paddling. Meanwhile, Chia and Darius start setting up shade. I run into the ocean with Lyra. Despite the weather, the waves are freezing to touch. Ah! Haha, you get used to it. Lyra swims up to me and clutches my arm. Come on, you know how to swim, right? I do not. I cannot swim. You can't swim? Alright, I'll teach you. Lyra grabs both of my hands. Just relax and lay forward into the ocean. I definitely don't think I'd be very comfortable learning to swim in the ocean. I don't know. I'd be kind of afraid of it. Huh. I do as she says and submerge myself in the ocean. Now bring your body up and kick your legs. Yep, like that. Can the spider girl swim? How would a spider person swim? Oh, I'm so confused. Okay. My movements are chaotic and unorganized at first, but I eventually gain a sense of rhythm as I lift one leg up, one down. My legs are like a pendulum. Estelle, you got it. The rest will come naturally. She lets go of my hands. I start to gasp out. Ah, wait. I fail my hands for a moment and then push them out in front of me to keep my balance. To my surprise, it truly does come naturally. In just a few seconds, I can keep myself above water while still moving. I'm swimming. Nice, Estelle. Good job. We swim for a while I practice keeping myself stable. Lyra eventually swims toward me. We should move out further, Estelle. There are too many sharp rocks here. Huh? Okay, no, bad idea. Stay near the beach. We pass through jagged rocks and swim deep into the ocean. The waves are a lot more violent and unstable here. Are you sure this is safer? It's fine. It's a lot safer than being near the shore. If you say so. A wave approaches and pushes me and Lyra back. Wasn't there a mermaid in the classroom? How do they get around? Like, do you think there's like a big bucket of water on like a Segway? I don't know. A wave approaches and pushes me and Lyra back. I use my leg to propel myself forward. Woohoo! We are completely drenched. We are swimming in the ocean? I spit and cough out salty water. Aqueducts. Oh, yes, okay. So there's like a canal system in between all the classrooms. That is definitely what is the case now. Another wave draws nearer to us. Get ready. In proportion to the last one, this one was tremendous and towering. It loomed over us and hit us with an immediate force. Gah! It tossed me aside like the powerless being that I was, and I very quickly became engulfed in seawater. We must have swum out far because I couldn't reach the bottom of the ground with my feet. Instead, I kept sinking and sinking below. I wanted to fight back, but I was, oh my gosh, have I got a bad ending? But I was in too much pain to think properly. Every part of my body aches for oxygen, but I hold my breath for as long as I can. I keep flailing my arms and legs like a fish out of water as I quietly drown beneath the sea. I keep holding my breath until I can't anymore, and I take deep gulps of salty seawater. I'm screaming, but I can't hear my voice. I succumb to the darkness around me. It's not as bad as I thought. In fact, I feel at peace as my consciousness fades away. I awaken to the sensation of something soft and salty pressed against my lips. A warm breath tickles my cheek. Then a strong force is pressed between my ribs. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cough, hack, wheeze. Ara, you okay? Gasp, cough. Lyra whacks me on the back. Ouch, too much Lyra. My mind is hazy as I try to grasp the situation. Did I drown? Estelle! You're alive! What were you thinking? I'm sorry, if I hadn't made you swim out far, I just didn't want you to hurt your foot on a rock. Instead, I almost drowned. I guess I'd rather lose my foot than my life. Sniff. Hey, look, all that doesn't really matter. I clear my throat. All that matters is that now I'm fine. Really? Yes. Then let me carry you back. Well, you don't have to. I start to protest, however my objections were in vain as I am lifted off the ground. Okay, monsters apparently love carrying humans around. At this point I'm like, what are the odds that Darius carries me somewhere at some point in this thing? Or the gelatinous cube. Maybe I get carried around in the gelatinous cube. Fingers crossed. Gelatinous cube. I start to protest, however my objections were in vain as I am lifted off the ground. Don't worry about it, Estelle. It's the least I could do. Hold on tight. She carries me in a way that is referred to as a bridal carry. Okay, I don't know what a bridal carry is, so if you know, please tell me. Her grip is strong and secure. Dot dot dot. Oh, even more dots. Well, let us go. When I arrive at my room, it's night outside. We're here. You didn't have to carry me all the way here. It's no biggie, Estelle. I'll see you tomorrow. Oh, right. I feel awkward, and I'm not really sure how to show my gratitude. I guess just saying thanks is fine. Lyra doesn't seem like a type to overthink things, or really think that much at all. But I genuinely am grateful. Thank you, Lyra. I'll see you tomorrow. Lyra waves and then makes her exit. The door slams behind her. Not out of anger, it's more likely the result of her inhuman strength, used on a door made for humans. It's been a long day. I bring my quilt up to my chin and fall asleep from exhaustion. Yeah, Yam, SVM, I really hope that today I get to be inside a gelatinous cube. That would be very exciting. After humid yesterday, today seems to be raining buckets. Yesterday must have been the calm before the storm. Thankfully, the rain made the building cooler, so I was grateful for that, even if it meant I couldn't go out. I grab my phone and make my way to class. During class, I stare outside to watch the rain. Most of the other monsters do the same. Does rainy weather not exist in your dimension? In your dimensions? Pay attention! I love this gelatinous cube so much. We reach the end of class. Try not to get distracted by the rain. Alright, lesson's over. You can go outside and play with the rain since you all love it so much. You seem to really hate rain, Nebula. Well, yes. Being in water is life-threatening to slimes because it would dilute my body. So if I was caught in the rain, my body would rapidly start to dissolve from the impact. I would most certainly die. That's harsh. Do you need help? Oh, please. I've been living in much worse climates for hundreds of years. I'm more worried about you catching a cold. Talking about you, Estelle. You should join a club, Estelle, if you're not in one already. Don't worry, Teach. Estelle is on the athletics team. Can I not be on the athletics team? Maybe? Is that so? Ah, that's good. Estelle looks like they need to get out more. Hey. Well, since it's raining, we can't really go outside. Huh? What do you mean, Estelle? It's a perfect opportunity to run in the rain. Rain never. I think that rain definitely has hurt people at times. Okay. We just established that the gelatinous cube will dissolve in the rain. Besides, I don't want to miss one day of training for such a small thing. And the coldness of the water will make you want to run faster. Is that how it works? Well, you, if you really don't want to, we can train in your room. Oh, there's no getting out of this, apparently. Okay. We should do some basic muscle training. Lyra looks around my room. You don't have any weights. I'm here for a week, Lyra. I don't do much exercise. Why don't we train in your room instead? Huh? No, here is fine. Oh, is there something in her room she doesn't want me to see? Okay. What do you think is in Lyra's bedroom? What would a werewolf be embarrassed about? Just really messy? Books? I don't know. I assume it's probably because her room is a mess. We can use our own weight anyway. Lyra lays flat on her stomach and pushes her hands up. Oh, pink everywhere. Just a very pink room. Like, covered in, like, flowers and frilly stuff. I could see Lyra being embarrassed by that. Lyra lays flat on her stomach and pushes her hands up. Let's start with the most basic of muscle building. Push-ups. Yeah. I lay next to her and place my hands under my chest. Carefully and slowly, I push against the floor and bring my face up. One. You can do it. Two, three, four. My heart beats faster and my body aches me to stop. It takes me forever to reach 10, but when I do, I feel proud. I collapse to the ground in a pile of my sweat. Lyra, however, is speeding through her push-ups. 95, 96, 97. You're kidding. 100. Phew. Keep working through it. Take a break. Aim for 100. Okay, Lyra is a terrible coach. Hey, person that doesn't do push-ups, you should try to do 100 push-ups. There's no way I can do that without going through cardiac arrest. Arrest? Then how about 80? That's still too much. Well, I need my post-workout meal. Try to push yourself, but don't get arrested. I think she might have misunderstood something. Okay, I try to do at least 20 more over the course of 3 hours. That seems a lot more reasonable. After working hard, I feel hungry. I don't normally eat after dinner. Maybe this means I worked hard? Thankfully, the canteen stays open through the night, probably for all the vampires and ghosts and stuff. I guess there are a lot of nocturnal monsters living here. I buy a sandwich and leave. I see Lyra, only her hair is a lot shorter. Did she cut her hair? It looks good. I walk up to her. Hey Lyra, nice hair. You also looking for an after workout meal? ... Question mark. Estelle. Lots of dots. Who the hell are you, human? Are you feeling okay? Lyra is my twin. Maybe the room is very pink. If Lyra shares a room with her twin. Lyra's a sister? She never mentioned this to me. I'm Luna. What business do you have with that bitch? Whoa. Whoa. Sorry, just predicting exactly what my character says. Didn't expect it. You have a bit of a mouth on you. I'm not sure that's a very nice term to call your sister, but potentially accurate? Oh, I think that term is pretty accurate, though. Who are you to tell me that anyway? I'm Estelle. I joined the athletic club with Lyra? Athletics? Human exercising? That's pretty funny. Just what kind of ideas do you have about humans? That we play video games all the time? I don't know why she wastes so much time with that. If she seriously wanted to become an adequate leader, she would do acrobatics like me. Hey human, want to join the acrobatics club? Yeah, let's join the acrobatics. That seems way more fun than running in the rain. Gross. That wasn't a choice. Don't actually answer that, you weirdo. I wouldn't want a human in our club. Harsh. Trash. Filth. Vermin. It was lovely to meet you too. Luna's terrible. She turns around and leaves without saying anything else. I guess that happened. Honestly, I'm glad she's gone. I'm sure this is why Lyra doesn't talk about her. I'm surprised two siblings can be so vastly different. That was exhausting. I can't wait to fall asleep as I sink into my bed. When I wake up, it dawns on me that today is Friday, my last day here, already. My last day with Lyra. Morning, Estelle. I set my things next to hers as I take a seat. Morning, Lyra. Today's my last day here. Does that mean I still have to go to athletics club? Not that I mind. Last day? It went by so quickly. It's up to you if you want to spend your last day athletics. I do not. But I'd like you if you went. Class begins, and we engage in the usual small talk. Ask her what she would like to do as a job in the future. Job? We don't have those where I'm from. Yep, seems great. Utopia. When we were hungry, we caught food. When we were tired, we napped. We talked to other animals when we were bored and migrated from our home with every few passings of the moon. That was what most of my years were like. So it's hard to wrap my head around this job and currency thing. Sounds relaxing. But as for job, here... Youngins. Like, a teacher? Sure. I'm not sure if she'd have anything to teach anyone. Maybe she could be a sports teacher? But you have to be smart for that, right? Class ends quicker than expected, and I say my farewells to everyone. Sniff. Bye, Estelle. Hey, I wouldn't mind spending one last day training with you. I mean, if you want to. Really? Yes. I was really hoping to not go running again. How about we do one last race around the whole track? I'll run right beside you the whole time. Sure. We do some light stretching and then get off to a slow start. My jaw quickly turns into a run as I pick up my pace. Lyra is next to me throughout it, grinning and saying words of encouragement. She deliberately runs it a lot slower than she normally does, as to match my tempo. That gesture honestly makes me happy. I want to run faster to impress her. Finish line. Good job. She ruffles my hair. I find it somewhat annoying, yet weirdly charming. You've improved so much. I actually feel like I can do one more lap. Want to go one more time? Yeah. I do have to walk an hour to the bus stop. Remember that. We continue to run until the sun starts to set. I'm exhausted, but that was fun. Are we ready to leave till tomorrow? Yeah. Uh-oh. Running, huh? Luna? Hanging out with a human? What in the world are you thinking? I know what happened, but I didn't think they're all like that. You really are weak-willed, huh? Being so friendly with a human. Did you think our family would be proud? Do you think they're glad you're spending so much time with a human? Don't say it like that. Look at you, makes me sick. Sniff. Pathetic. This is why you'll never be fit to lead. Luna, I just want it to be like it used to. No, stop. I don't want to hear it. Luna. This looks like a personal matter between siblings. I feel like I should leave. But what kind of friend would I be to Lyra if I didn't step in? I just want to leave. I'm gonna go. Gross. Weak. Pathetic. She twirls around and walks off. Sniff. Sob. Let's talk back at my room. So what's her deal? We used to be a lot closer. At the start. Me and Luna used to share a close and friendly rivalry. Do you think they have human ears? Or just the wolf ears? Would the sides of their heads just be like completely smooth and flat? That seems really weird to me for some reason. I don't know. I'm glad to see that Luna seems to have weirdo piercings in her wolf ears, though. We are both the same age, only seconds apart, and oldest of our siblings, so we've always fought to be the next leader of our pack. That's what our life was like for so many years, until we were transported here. When we first arrived, our parents were missing. It was only me, Luna, and our siblings. But even then, nothing had changed about our relationship. The only thing that was different is that we had our younger pups to look after. We had many younger siblings. Due to us having to work a lot, we took it in turns to look after them. I took care of them Monday through Wednesday, and Luna had Thursday to Saturday. And then on Sunday, we both shared Sunday. I'm like, on Sunday, we left them to fend for themselves. It was chaotic, but fun. And that's when our school was burnt down by humans. On that day, I was supposed to look after them. It's all my fault, and I know Luna was, oh my gosh, did all of her siblings die? And I deserve it. No. There's no way you deserve to be blamed. Something as horrible as that was completely out of your control. And there's no way you could have prevented it on your own. Estelle. Thank you. I know that my last day is officially today. But if you want to, let's train again tomorrow. Yeah! I'm reluctant to do it at first, but I decide to throw my arms around the wolf. It must have been tough for you. Yeah. She squeezes me back. After a long and slightly awkward embrace, we separate. It's getting late, so I should probably go. But I'll see you tomorrow morning. First thing. Oops. Ooh, red blood moon. Whoa, is that a snake? What's going on? I'm so... a ghost? So mysterious. Which... I'm glad I went back to this. I didn't realize how much animation, like animated stuff there'd be. I wake up feeling tense. There's a cold atmosphere in my room that makes my hair stand on end. My room is illuminated with a red light. Oh, I can tell you why, Estelle. It's because the forest is on fire. Everything's on fire. I look out my window to discover the source of this light. A beautiful full red moon shines right above the night sky. Wait, has the moon always been red here? It gives me the same unsettling vibes I had back in that forest. Something heavy impacts my door. Whoa. There's another slam on my door as if a strong force is being slammed against it. Estelle, the font that Lyra's name was in has changed. Come out and play. Is that Lyra? What's wrong with her? There's yet another slam on my door. Her voice doesn't sound natural. Is this just a game she's playing? Yet, her voice gives me an uncanny feeling. I'm not sure what to do. But if I don't think fast, I'm not sure what will happen. What should I do? Wait in bed, hide under the bed, escape out the window, open the door. Whoa, waiting in bed and wolves leads to being eaten. Don't know if hiding under the bed is a much better option. Opening the door seems like definitely a poor option. I'm thinking window. Kira, you're thinking window as well. So I think let's go with escaping out the window. We'll probably fall to our deaths, but those are just how it falls sometimes. I open my window as far as it can be pushed open. It's a little bit squeezed, but I think I can make it. I climb out and hold onto the drainage pipes outside my room. I normally wouldn't be able to do this, but with my week of training here, I feel that climbing down these pipes is a lot easier. Not that it is easy, of course. These pipes are still difficult to grasp onto and support my weight. My heart is beating rapidly and my legs are trembling. Carefully, carefully. The pipes are unstable and feel like they're going to give out any minute, but I'm almost there. Just a little more. I'm so close. But I lose my grip. I fall into the earth below with a slam. I twinge at the pain. Thankfully, I hadn't fallen very far. But the pain in my body is intense. I don't have time to cry out about it, though. I need to escape. Shit. My foot might be broken. Staying here is suicide, and so the only choice I have is to run. Every time I move my foot, a wave of howling pain is sent through my body. I can't bring myself to focus on it. The only thing I care about is leaving. Adrenaline has overrun every other feeling in my body, and I force myself to keep on moving. I half wobble, half run into the forest I was once at before. The pain is excruciating, but I can't stop. Tears and mucus stream down my face. Pretty sure I've gotten one of the bad endings. I just want to go home. Going somewhere. Luna? I need to move fast. My legs feel like they're on fire. My eyes are watering, but all I can think about is getting out of here. I can't die here. Not like this. Quickly. I need to get off here. Run. Oh, okay. So do I go with run number one, run number two, or run number three? I wonder if there's actually any difference. Run one? Yeah, I think just run number one is the best one to go with. Let's go with that one. The most immediate one. Okay. Gross. You don't have a choice. You think you can outrun me? You can't. Ha, Luna, you're a gymnast, not a runner. Maybe I can outrun you. I attempt to turn back and run. Oh, I guess my foot's broken. But I move too fast. My broken foot collides with a rock, and it's enough to send me onto my face. I can feel the blood trickle down my face. Before Luna can even approach me, I start to pass out from the pain. The last thing I hear is Luna crackling with vicious laughter. Bad ending, rock. I guess I should have chosen to interrupt when they were arguing with when she was insulting Lyra. Oh no, the end. Bad ending. Well, I did say I was gonna get one of the bad endings, and I did. Did not expect the bad endings to be that bad. I really thought it would be like, oh no, I didn't get to make out with them, or like I spilled punch on the witch. Instead, it was I got like eaten by evil gymnast werewolf. Yeah. Okay. Cool. This was fun. I like this one. This is great. This was made for I think it's the Spooktober visual novel competition last year in 2019. So you can go check it out. I guess there's like another 10 endings, which is really neat. I'm not gonna play any of them right now on stream, but maybe I'll come back to those in the future. We'll see. So next week I will be playing another spooky game. I don't remember what it is called. But yeah, every Friday, 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific, I'll be streaming spooky stuff here on Twitch, spooky visual novels. Which ones I'll be doing in October, I don't know yet, because I'm going to be doing the Spooktober Visual Novel Fest 2020 entries, and those are not finished yet. People are still working on those right now. I will also mention my podcast again. It is called... Where is it? Here it is, Book Club for Masochists. You can go to bookclubform.com. Our episode about visual novels came out just a couple weeks ago, so you can listen to us talk about visual novels if you want to. And we do two episodes a month. One is about a genre or format of books, and the other is about a book-like subject. Give me suggestions for visual novels to watch. Give me suggestions for other spooky stuff to check out. And thanks for joining me on the stream today. I may have died, but this is still a fun game to play. And I hope you had fun as well. Happy Halloween! Bye.